Okay, we're going to do a little test. Let's see if you can figure out what I'm saying. Okay, if you could tell what it was I was saying, know that I mean it from the bottom of my heart. And if you can't, that means you can't read lips. And that means that you are... Furries, going to school in the mid-1990s like I did, you were never more than 15 feet from a copy of Alanis Morissette's album Jagged Little Pill. And for a poetry major living with a young lady, I heard this album. It's a classic. I love it. Songs from this album make it into every playlist I ever make. And I listen to the full album pretty much every time I'm cleaning. You know, anytime I'm cleaning something, like the office or the house, I'm always listening to Jagged Little Pill. One of the main complaints about the album, still, after all this time, comes from the nitpicky and pedantic. And it's regarding the song Ironic. They still get all worked up over the fact that the song Ironic contains some not at all ironic things. They still rail on it. 17 years later, people are still railing on that song. Children who were conceived during the song can now drive, and people have not yet gotten over it. Listen, it's a great pop song. It's catchy, it's bouncy, and regardless of exactly how catchy and bouncy it is, people still attack it for its lyrical content. You know these people. You realize, of course, that Starships, We Built This City on Rock and Roll isn't actually a rock and roll song, right?
It's Gnarlsby, the art house film dork that ripped my ear.
Now, I'm going to admit my love for the song. I do love this song. I'm also aware of its shortcomings. Doesn't reduce my love for it. And I submit that perhaps true irony... So, I endeavored to help Alanis and the rest of the world by taking the lyrics of Ironic and pumping up the ironic content.
An old man turned 98. He won the lottery and he died the next day.
But see, he bought the lottery ticket with a dollar he had stolen from the doctor, who told him he would live another 5 years.
It's a black fly in your Chardonnay.
At a charity wine tasting thrown by Motherbugger, leading makers of black fly repellent.
It's a death row pardon, 2 minutes too late.
When you had convinced everyone that you were innocent, when you were really guilty.
It's like rain on your wedding day.
To a meteorologist who had selected this time of year and this arid desert for your wedding because of lack of rainfall.
It's a free ride when you already paid.
For someone to pick you up from prison where you spent the last 9 months for taxicab fraud.
It's the good advice that you just didn't take.
About taking bad advice.
Mr. Play It Safe, he was afraid to fly. He packed his suitcase and kissed his kids goodbye. He waited his whole damn life to take that flight, and as the plane crashed down, he thought, well, isn't this nice?
Actually, that one's pretty good. I really don't need to admit it. It's fairly ironic.
Well, life has a funny way of sneaking up on you when you think everything's okay and everything's going right. And life has a funny way of helping you out when you think everything's gone wrong and everything blows up in your face.
There's really nothing to change in the bridge since it seems less concerned with irony than just a kind of an overall sense of irony. Not to mention turning life into some sort of trickster character that likes to mess with us.
A traffic jam when you're already late.
To a city council meeting about bad traffic conditions.
A no smoking sign on your cigarette break.
At your tobacco company job.
It's like 10,000 spoons when all you need is a knife.
To perform emergency life-saving surgery on Lawrence Balkin, president of the pro-spoon organization More Spoons Than Knives.
It's meeting the man of my dreams and then meeting his beautiful wife.
Yeah, you're on your own with this one. I can't really think of a way to make it ironic. I mean, it's sad, sure, but ironic, unless...
like meeting the man of my dreams and then meeting his beautiful wife.
even though I've been a lesbian my whole life, and his beautiful wife is my former long-term partner and first love, the woman of my dreams. Ha ha! I think I nailed that one. Ironically, as I was working on this, I found out that collegehumor.com did almost the exact same thing, except they actually turned it into a song. But I'm not going to chuck this in the dumpster. Nope. I will just put a link down in the litter box to the College Humor video. Go and take a look. It's pretty good. I liked it. Yeah. And we only made one joke that was exactly the same. You know, at the end of the day, my hope is that Alanis Morissette and her co-writer Glen Ballard are having the last laugh, because they knew what they were doing all along, making the song ironic only in its lack of irony. Alanis just works on a level most people don't get. I love you, Alanis. I'll see you furries later. Ciao.